Hi, welcome back. I've pushed this on quite a bit, but I've had a real struggle with techniques. I tried the sponging and I wasn't really happy with it. Didn't really do what I wanted it to do. So I'm just going to work at this a bit and then put in some of these branches, which really establish the fact that they're trees. So it's a very similar background to the sky. So you just have to bear with me while I do all this. Fast forward if you get a bit bored. So I've got alizarin, a bit of ultramarine, a lot of white, of course. I'm building up a very nice texture on this, on the surface with me stipple. I can't very well show you what I'm copying from, but of course it might well be copyright. So I'm just doing my version of it. But you can find out what I'm looking at if you Google cherry blossom in an English landscape, photos of. And you can have a go at what I'm doing or copy mine. But just a bit of the bottom here, just catching this nice lovely yellow, light yellow foliage showing through. Oh, just put some boughs covered, but a lot of the darker colour really is shadow. But this won't look much until I start putting the branches in. So I'm going to put a little bit of yellow in with the white for the base of these trees. Let's just clean my palette off a bit. I've got my cup of tea. I've had my lunch, so no need to stop now. We'll work this to the death. We'll see how we go. Right, white. Back to the stipple. Stipple is a very, very good technique. That probably is a little bit too. I just want the light to show underneath. Nice and bright behind there, just to show some winter, some spring green catching the light. Right, let's go back with some of my nice alizarin. Just put a few in here. Bit too lumpy there. I'll work with the rigger in a minute just to get some, not a lot to be done here. I've got to put some detail in it, but there's sort of a pathway going through. It's quite a nice colour. More peachy than pinky. Right. Get some lighter. See, I can only do an impression of it. I can't paint every single one. I'm just trying to find, look for lights. Put them in. And then we've got sort of bows covered. Sort of a like a cherry orchard, isn't it, really? Alright, we'll let that go for a minute and then get a rigger. I've got my old computer. I've started up, hasn't been working for 90 odd days. I've been using the tablet mostly. It's a Lynx tablet. And a bit of blue and burnt umber for the bows, for the plenty of water. A lot of water for your brush because the rigger won't pick up very much. I'm just showing through and I'll put some coming in from over the picture. We've got lots of, we go around the bend here, we've got lots of trees in here. If you make a mistake, you can always stipple back over it. It's starting to come to life a little bit. The light is coming from here, so I'm going to have to put some of that back. Talk about making rods for backs. Certainly done it here. To a very special friend, and I know she'll like it. So because we've got so much paint here, we can hit and miss in quite a bit of this. We just hit the high spots. That's on. Going down. Use the side of your brush just to tap. Going off. Go into the distance, just okay, getting somewhere. Remember, just don't want to walk in the same way. See, I'm holding my brush. Alright, so we've got a sort of recession going on there. Now we want some lights now. So put green. Just catching the sunlight. And we can always go over, back over. I want to alter some of the shapes. These are a bit regimented, so I don't like that. So I'm going to just try to change the direction a little bit. Go back to my ultramarine burnt umber. Look at that one. Better. Nice little bit of lemony, sort of greeny yellow. Catching the light. A bit lighter than that, eh? Okay, that'll do for that. For a minute, let's go back over the path now. What we've got was this cast shadow over there. I'm just going to cast shadow brush and just put in a bit of dark, a bit of red, blue, this room. Mm-hmm. Like that. Yeah. Now we can get some nice, brilliant greens in there. I've got to drink my tea. Maybe just a little bit more dark, and though these shadows are a bit, these here, they're just a little bit too. A bit of black with that. Right. Yeah, don't be afraid of black. Okay, now near these bright, brilliant greens. So, lemon yellow, bit of white, bit of the pale yellow, a bit pale green. Just on the top of it, just catching the tops of these. Light just shining through. I'm sort of in overdoing this just to make it clearer. Oh, just nice bits of sunlight dappling through. Oh, just dragging over the high spots in here. Less distinct and more and smaller. Just to give that lovely light. Some of that shadow there, just make these less distinct as we go off into the murk. Okay, nice bit of this pale yellow, pale green is a real good colour. Now I don't want to hit that because I want that. Alright, okay, that seems to be doing the trick. Bit of nice light ochre in there. Just helps us. Effective light, I hope. Well, we go back to a bit of a detail in there. Let's just get a bit more light going through here. Oh, just touching the brush. And in between the shadows. It's not too obvious. That's a bit in your face from there. Just clean the brush. I'll just go with some nice dark bits there, dark green, bit of black, bit of red, bit of yellow. Oops. You quickly overpaint. Right, let's just get that a little bit more hard, is there? Ooh, why did I do that? I'll let that dry. Well, I want to go over this little bit here, just a little bit of really light. Nice light detail in it. And then what I'll do, I'll put the twigs, more twigs up here. I'll make sure I'm finished around the edges and I'll just have a look at it and we'll put it in a frame. Right, so. Right, nice bit of brilliant stepper in here. Oh, I reckon a couple of poppies in there. Can I miss? Right, swear for me. Right. So you have to remember to take them off the page or off the board. Otherwise it looks as if you've filled in the frame. So you just hint you that. Right, I think that is just about far enough advanced to put in a frame, so bear with me. I've only got a crafty type of frame. They were all the rage once, but now people go for plain frames. So there we are, we've got almost there, a bit more stipple I think. So let's just have some fun with a stipple. Some more whites, some pure whites, glistening. Pretty yellowy stipple. Just underneath where the light's going to come, underneath there. think anything more, much more than this. I don't know if I can do. Oops. I'll fix it in the frame in a minute. Just gives me an idea of how we're doing. Oh, let's just have a little bit of play here. Did I say puppies? Would you have puppies out so early? Well, it's okay, that just gives that little bit of red. David Dickinson describes it, the Turner trick. Well, I'll just put a couple of nails in that. So twiddle your thumbs while I just bang it up there, just to hold it. I looked at it upside down and I thought, hello, that's not what I painted. I'll have to sign it. Well, there we are. I hope you can see that. Let's sign it with this rigger. Right, so very little detail on this. It looks a lot, but it's all done with a stipple, apart from bits and pieces, but it's generally probably needs a little bit more white. Then that'll throw the obvious blues back a little bit. And the viewer will have to make up their own mind whether they are sky or fronds. Right, just a little bit. Maybe that's a bit of a step too far there. I'll soon rectify that. Go back and put a bit more white over it. White. This is where you fiddle around for ages and ages. Just throw more paint at it. Right, no more, that is it, that's enough. Give in. Right, let's have a zoom in. Oops. So there's our shadow in that path I've not over elaborated the path, but I've tried to create space for the light coming through the trees. I don't know if it's effective or not, but my poppies, well, I like them. So, very roughly painted. I suppose in all this has taken about 2 hours to do. There was a bit that where my sponging didn't go well, so I spared you that. So there we are. Now, whether I get time to do some tomorrow, I don't know. That seems to be hanging a bit. Got to be attached to something, isn't it? All right, well, I could do that for hours, and so could you, so let's quit while we're sort of ahead. So, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.